Hey guys, it's Kim and Dan.
One of the first projects we tackled when we bought our house was installing a new screen door for our fireplace.
Our original screen door looked a little outdated.
More importantly, it wasn't safe for our mischievous birds who like to climb on it when they're not supposed to.
Hey, Bijou, what are you doing?
Bijou!
Bijou, stop it!
Bijou! Stop Bijou. It! Someone stop her!
Bijou.
Bijou.
Stop that.
So we went ahead and installed a new cover a few months ago.
Just so you know, this was the first video we made here in the new house. We didn't have any furniture or any fancy camera equipment with us.
I had on manual focus and you were blurry the entire time. Oops.
So bear with us during the first half of the video, and in the second half, we'll show you how we decorated our mantle.
I hope this inspires you to fix up your own fireplace. What do you have there, Dan?
I have a new fireplace cover.
A few struggles later.
The first step is to put the handles on. You get a couple brackets that's gonna go on the side of the fireplace and it's gonna help you secure it to the wall. And then also with these brackets comes these big screws. And they're nice because they're toolless. They've got little finger tabs and they're really pointy, so they're gonna dig into the brick.
Do you know how to do it like a beauty blogger? You hold the screw up like this with your hand. No, that's not how the beauty gurus do it.
But I'm beautiful. Moustache. Different style of moustache. Handles.
It's not, it's still this packaging.
For handling. No, there's handles in there.
Way to go.
Like this?
Yes!
Am I beautiful?
Yeah, you're like the beauty guru.
Look at these nice handles.
Now, like, move it around.
These nice handles.
Wrong way. They don't care about your hands, they just want to see the handles.
Okay, so we're going to do a test fit of the fireplace cover in the fireplace, see if it covers the hole, and also to see if we need this. This is a riser, so it goes on the bottom of the fireplace cover to go up here, and then it just lifts it up an inch or two in case your fireplace opening is too tall. We're gonna be very careful to try to keep our grubby fingers off the glass.
Cause I said so.
My wife will notice. I think we do need the riser in after all.
I can't get all the way in there, but pinky. There, there's a gap.
The fireplace cover on its front and then the riser facing forward and the little dots facing up. We're gonna use a machine screw and then a lock nut to attach the riser.
So you get it lined up and you use your foot to hold the riser.
Okay.
And your two fingers tighten up the screw and the lock nut. And you look a little crazed. Just cause.
No, I was gonna say you look a little crazy because it's a Friday night and you just finished a 10-hour shift.
Yes, that. I just finished 10 hours at work and it's Friday and this is what I get to do on Friday.
It looks comically large.
It is comically large. This is entirely overkill, but when you're moving, you don't have all your tools. And this is what I got. So this is what we're using.
I like that you're reading with your screwdriver.
For this next step, we're going to use fiberglass insulation that actually came with our fireplace. If you've ever worked with this, it makes you really, really itchy and it irritates your skin and stuff. So wear some sort of gloves.
They look like two long french fries.
All done.
Hi, I'm Kim from behind the camera. So Dan is letting me take the sticker off.
This is the most important job.
And most satisfying.
You're gonna wanna zoom in.
Oh, usually I leave stickers on, but this is kind of essential that you take it off. Oh, so good. Ta-da! And just like that, our fireplace cover was installed.
Now we can show you how we decorated it.
Hey guys, we experienced some technical difficulties with our audio, so I will be narrating from this point on. It's probably for the best because we're still really awkward on camera. Anyway, so When you're trying to decorate your fireplace mantle, it's good to start with the main focal point. We chose three picture frames of varying sizes that we've layered on top of each other. If you have one big statement piece, like a mirror, that's a great place to start too. We bought this big gray frame on sale at Michael's. I swear, this frame has got to be one of their best sellers because I've seen this used in so many other homes. We chose to frame a map of Block Island, which is where we got married. Our next frame is from Amazon. It's pretty flimsy, to be honest, but it was cheap and it just sits on our mantle, so it's fine. This is one of my favorite photos of us from the wedding. Lastly, we have a small shadow box frame, also from Michael's, holding a beautiful quill card that we got from a guest at, you guessed it, our wedding. We actually got this card twice, so that shows how well our family knows us and our style. Next up, we added some greenery. Ours is a super trendy faux garland made to mimic silver dollar eucalyptus. I just did a quick Google search and there's a ton of options online. Again, we used this for our wedding, and now it lives in our home. Having fake greenery adds some life to the room while still being convenient and easy compared to a real garland. We also have some real plants. This is a baby rubber plant and a snake plant. The only caveat I have is that I suggest removing these when you actually use your fireplace because the change in temperature might upset them. Also, I don't know, you might accidentally set them on fire? That's a big no-no. Now, what's a fireplace mantle without some candles? Ours came in a big set from Amazon. Since we have birds with sensitive lungs, ours are fake. But the best part about having fake candles is that you can set them to turn on at the same time every night with a remote. Since these are battery powered, we recommend buying some rechargeable batteries along with this set. To add to the ambiance of the room, we added this IKEA lantern with Christmas lights to the base of our fireplace. At the time of filming this, it was December, so we wanted to put in some holiday decorations too. We have the cutest deer from Home Goods, and then we have these cute birds that are still in stock at Target. They're the cutest thing ever, I'm obsessed. This one is named Powell, and this one is named Pear. We also have little stockings from Target, a D for Dan, K for Kim, and B for our birds, Benji and Bijou. Lastly, we wanted to show off some personal things we liked as well. This sloth reminds me of Dan. So there you have it.
Thanks for watching.
If you want to see details on our fireplace cover, we'll leave a link in the description below.
And stay tuned. We just got a table saw, and we got some woodworking DIYs planned for the future that we think you'll enjoy.
Bye.
Bye.